All right, welcome back. This is a match two with our black-white vintage cube draft. This hand is not ideal. It's not gonna do anything against a traditional cube deck, so we're gonna ship it. Sand is also not great, but I don't really want to go to five. There's the scrub land we're gonna search out with our marsh flats. And Mana Vault. Recurring Nightmare is a thing. We'll go Godless Shrine first, because if we're just getting scrub lands with marsh flats, there's no reason to not get that next turn. It's going to cost us one. Whereas if we put Godless Shrine into play any other turn, it's probably going to cost us two if we want to use it. So just a little bit of a life savings there. Here we go. We're going to play like a Garrick. All right. It's not great, but it is a scary card. Hence why we have the disenchant in the sideboard. And why we took it over War Priest of Thune. What if they just pass here? That'd be great. I don't have any creatures. I mean, I have to assume if you had a dude, you'd play it over this, but. Oh boy. Primeval Titan? No, just a Garrick. Sure. Equip. Oh, alright. So, this is good times. Let's get old Scrubby. Oh, fashionably late to the party, Stoneforge Mystic, and now you get to die to a Jitte. That's unfortunate. I guess we get a Batterskull. What are the odds they don't kill our Stoneforge Mystic? Probably like zero, right? So we can go Linvala. Oh god, Jitte is so good. If they can connect once, your combat's basically impossible. Yep. Oh boy. And dead. Yep, that did not last long. However, no counters, so we can play Linvala and block the beast. They could pay three. Oh, no, they can't actually untap Mana Vault because they don't have four, and it only triggers during the upkeep. It's not like Basalt Monolith where you can just untap it whenever you want. If we can get to Sun Titan, I feel okay, but right now our curve is looking like this. Oh, Guy's Cradle. How nice. Make a beast. Make five. Oh, good. Oh, wonderful. Oh, wonderful white deck. Or green deck. Yep, there's a lot of creatures. It's actually not terrible, but. We're not dead yet. I think Jitte is the biggest problem here. 19 turns, they may be dead. I guess they're figuring out whether they want to pay four and untap this. If they attack with Oracle, we're just blocking Oracle. If they attack with Beast, we're just going to block. Obviously. Unfortunately, I was hoping the Jitte's ability would be given to the creature, but no such. Oh, drew one planeswalker. Top deck another one. All right. Yep. Just play your Nissa. And 10 mana, huh? This is just Genesis Wave? Yep, it always is. Alright. Oh, that was a Green Sun Zenith, not a Genesis Wave. So, yeah, alright. That's cool. That was a fun and interactive game. Oh, and there's a Frailes on top, so it's just mono green planeswalkers, I guess. So, bring the Damnation in. Wall of Omen seems not terrible, but not great either. Maze of Ith could be good here. I don't know. Probably not. Well, I mean, if they have a guy with a Jitte on it, it's reasonable. Do we bring Disenchant in just for Jitte? Probably. Wall of Omens can probably come out. Sort of War and Peace can come out. Just because it's another target for Stoneforge is not really good enough. Wonder if Hypnotic Spectre may be good enough. Might be just better than something like Brimaz. Feels far more likely to get through, and also makes them discard relevant cards, perhaps. Kind of want Shieldred in here, to be honest. Take the Linvala out, I'll bring a Shieldred. Yeah, that seems interesting. Let's try it like that. I mean, if we can find a way to Recurring Nightmare of Shieldred, that's pretty sweet. I'll keep this hand. Reluctantly. I think our deck's a little too fair, to be honest with you, but they're just playing green cards, and there's a dude. Alright, the old six lands, two spells, always a recipe for success, Magic Online, and never predictable at all. Interesting, missed the land drop. Oh, seven lands, two spells. Just getting better. Not even a Marsh Flats that we could sacrifice to get back with our Sun Titan. Can you play three more mana guys and have us draw a Damnation? That would be ideal. However, if you're not going to draw us the Damnation, don't let them play mana, guys. So. Genesis Wave for. Or Green Sun Zenith for two, perhaps? Another mana guy. Alright. Ophiomancer. Well, that's pretty good. Because we can get a Snake Man out now. Snakes, 4 days. One snake for 1 day. Discard a thing. I don't know what's going on right now. Green Sun for one. Another mana dude. I guess this is how we win this match. There you go. Alright, so if we do draw Damnation, it's just great for us. Okay, we'll just draw another land instead. I'm just gonna alpha here. They're not gonna block Ophiomancer with Fauna Shaman. Oh, or are they? Well, next turn Sun Titan gets real good then. They also didn't activate it, so that's good. Yeah, now Sun Titan can just get back a card, and this is exactly that's why we actually ran the Ophiomancer into him. Not expecting it to actually happen. There's definitely a situation where Sword of Fire and Ice would be, or Sword of War and Peace would be great. Garrick. Well, on the bright side, we can just kill Garrick, which is nice. Definitely okay with that trade. Send two spirits over at Garrick. Oh my god. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 9 lands to 3 spells. That's unreal. At your face, at Garrick, at your face. Okay, Garrick, Garrick, Garrick. Face, face. Okay, so we're good. I will say yes. Oh, we just go to the next game. Thankfully, because I had a handful of... Well, I guess we could just Mind Twist you next turn, but yeah, that hand was not ideal. Alright, so... They definitely had a million dudes. Sword of War and Peace is also nice because it lets us redirect the damage to their face. I don't know if I like Spear here, actually. Might be too slow. I think Sword is just better than Spear here. What else is good? Is Linvala better than Hero of Bladehold? Actually, yes, because they have a bunch of mana creatures. And she flies, which is very, very good against whatever they're doing. Also, Brain Maggot seems also pretty reasonable. Might take out Fiend Hunter for Brain Maggot. I don't think we care about getting rid of a single creature, especially when we have... Damnation in here to get them away, to sweep them away. Yeah, so we'll try it like this. I think this is probably a better configuration anyway, so. But of course, everyone's going to say that about their most recent configuration. Oh boy, Magic Online. We have a good time. Yeah, all right, sure. Nope. Wow. Two planes, Misha's factory into three planes, Misha's factory into, or was it four? I don't even know. All right. Let's see if we can draw a non. Actually, you know what? Even if you give me a planes here, I'll be fine. Two mana guys, because that's how you do. I guess that's a mana guy. Where's that Linvala when we needed it? Oh, hey, look at that. Pretty sure we just want to kill this, but I don't think it does anything. Good morning, good morning. All right. So they have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana right now. That's actually unbelievable. This is turn 3. They can Genesis Way out. Yeah, that's a good one. And now you just kill Smuggler's Copter? Of course you do. Yeah, because they got something else. That's good. Alright, you're doing well for yourself. Now you can play another free land. Oh boy. One card in hand. Who knew Mind Twist would be so poorly positioned right now? Awkwardly, if we play Blade Splicer, you're just going to Conclave Naturalists and kill it. Ugh. Unfortunately, Frailes makes pluses 2, which means we can't actually kill her next turn. Still think it's Lingering Souls here. I would make this bigger like I'm doing right now, but it's just gonna get smaller as soon as the card changes, because that is a tricky thing to program, I guess. You got it. Yep, there it is. Wow. Alright, so Naturalists. Conclave on top. And a Nissa on top. Not even sure we can draw. Like, I don't want to land here, but there's a ton of cards that need land, so. Conclave Naturalists? Oh, it's a May ability. That's real sad. Well, now I feel better about playing Blade Splicer. Attack with Oracle here? I'll probably just attack with Oracle here. Pressure is good. And we don't know the one card in your hand. Next turn, you're obviously going to play Nissa, which is unfortunate to say the least. If we drew a land here, it'd actually be fine, because we can cast Lingering Souls and Ultimate Price. Oh, Shieldred. How much mana do they have here, actually? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, makes 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 mana? That's pretty good. And Nissa on top. Yeah, I don't think we can actually beat a Nissa, unfortunately. I'm pretty sure we can barely beat this Frailes, so. Unfortunately, the old 3-0 is out of our grasp now, it seems. Garrick on top, okay. I ain't scared. We got this. Okay. I guess that was the one card in your hand. Oh, boy. You know what? I'm going to let you do it, because that's good times. You go ahead. You knock yourself out. Block. They still got me? I think we might be fine. Okay, now, we were close. It was close. Fair game. Alright. We'll see you guys in round 3.